Right, time for a predictions video. This one is a midweek UFN event, so apologies for the fact that, you know, it's almost upon us, but I can only do my prediction videos, only have time at the weekend, so if they do the midweek, you only get a day or two. Firstly, to say that I didn't do too badly in my last predictions video, considering it was the Oriental event where I sort of didn't really know anyone. I got half marks on that, so to speak. My fighter of the card for that is, in fact, the winner of their main event. It's Tariq Safadin for that. So he'll be entered into our Fighter of the Year competition, as all the Fighters of the Card Award winners are. As it's another UFN event, I'm only going to speak in detail on a few matches, and the rest are quick picks, and of course you can see my full predictions in the closing credits at the end. The quick picks then, they've got Yoel Romero and Derek Brunson. Derek Brunson is somebody that you ought to have heard of. He is an up-and-comer. Can't remember where from now, but I do know. Now, this one wasn't quite as easy to call as I thought. I was originally just thinking Derek Brunson, but when I looked into Yoel Romero, I think that Brunson has to be on his best to do well here, but I'm going to say that I think he'll do that. So I'm going for a TKO in the third there for him. John Moraga is fighting Dustin Ortiz, and Dustin Ortiz is, in my opinion, a big step down from fighting for the title. And you'll remember, I think, that John Moraga went all the way to the fifth round before he lost in the title match. So I think he'll do okay here, but I'm going to go for a decision victory for him. Cole Miller is fighting Sam Cecilia, and I'm going to go for Cole Miller here. I'm going to go for a bar submission in the second. That seemed, you know, quite an obvious one to me to call. Isaac Villaflag is fighting Elias Silverio, or something like that. I'm going to go for Isaac. TKO in the first there. Trevor Smith is fighting Brian Houston. Trevor Smith hasn't been doing so well recently, but I do think that this is going to be a match where he'll do well. So I'm going for a choke submission in the second for him. And that will put him back onto the right sort of streak. Alptekin Ozkilic and Lewis Smolka, I think. I think this is a little bit of a squash match here. And I do think that Alptekin is supposed to win. He did, if I remember, win his last one, but it could have been a close call. It might have been a decision or a split decision. It could have been close. And I think he'll win this one a lot more convincingly, but I'm going to go still for decision there. Vink Pichel is fighting Garrett Whiteley, and I'm going to go for Vink Pichel winning by TKO in the second. Their last match here is interesting because it's Charlie Brennerman. Yes, the one and the same. If you remember him back a long time ago, he's been out in other organisations since, and he's coming back now. He's fighting somebody called Benil Dariush or something. Not to be sniffed at, because I hear that he has links to Vondelay and his fight team, but I do think that Charlie Brennerman, all going well here, should win this one. I'm going to go for a decision still, though. Their main event is Luke Rockhold versus Costas Philippou, two people who are quite high up there, but both coming off losses, and yet they're still main event. It's funny that, isn't it? There we are. Costas has a record of 12-3, wins by TKO mostly, loses by decision. He has never been submitted, okay? He's never been finished. Now, Luke Rockhold, I imagine, is going to want to get a submission victory here. His record is 10-2. Wins by submission, loses by TKO. You know, I think Luke Rockhold will win, but I'm not actually quite sure how. I'm not sure whether he will be able to be the first one to give Costas a submission loss, or whether he'll just win by decision. But I'm still going to go with him winning. Lorenz Larkin is next versus Brad Tavares. Lorenz Larkin, 14-1, has a long background in strike force. Brad Tavares, 11-1. He's on a 4-fight win streak, but I don't think he's fought quite as good calibers. You know, he is a bit of a decision king, is Brad, and Lorenz Larkin tends to finish. I'm going to give Lorenz Larkin the nod here, I think, and say that I think he's going to win by his favoured method, TKO in the third. TJ Dillashaw is fighting Mike Easton. Mike Easton has a record of 13-3, but he is two losses in a row here. So he could be in trouble if he loses this one. He's also a decision king. TJ Dillashaw is 8-2. He's coming off a loss, but I favour him on this one, I think. I'm going to give him the benefit of the doubt and say I think he'll get a decision victory. The final match on the whole card is Justin Edwards versus Ramzi Najim. Now, this is interesting. Ramzi Najim is a former tougher. He is coming off two losses in a row. Not only that, in both of those losses he's been finished. His record 7-4, not brilliant. Justin Edwards, not too much better I suppose, 8-3. And his past record is ridiculous. Win, loss, win, loss, win, loss. You know, he's a big one for submissions, is Justin Edwards. Bit worried that Ramsey's not going to be able to withstand the attacks there. So I think if Justin's got his head on, he might win this one. And I'm going to go for a bar submission in the second. And that is my predictions for this UFN event.